talk about, obviously, is Westown Resort. The Westown Resort, as you all know, has been the gold standard for calendar event creation and schedule management. People love about the notifications, love about the simplicity of this application. And today I'm going to give you a quick update. So we're so excited to announce that there has been 1,200,000 events created by Westown Resort. So as you all have asked, very recently, so what would happen after you leave? Well, I brought you good news. We're introducing something called LTS, which stands for long-term support. So as long as we use my backpack, resort's gonna work. Polaris. Polaris, as you all know, has been around for about a year, and it's the weekend program management system. And there has been 10,000 individual signups so far.
Yes!
And plus, we'll be celebrating our 1,000th Polaris trip this weekend.
Woo!
I'm so excited that we'll provide everyone a special gift on that trip. Okay, next up, let's talk about some of the new features we've implemented, as well as how I've learned through this process. There are over 30 new features that will be introduced to the next Polaris. I only have the time to talk about three of them. First of all, as you all know, we love travelers. We love all of you who've been taking full advantage of the weekend program. We've got many trips every weekend. Go to different activities, go to Target, go to shopping malls, to the movies. We want you to do that. But after a couple of weeks into our initial release, we learned that there are people who game the system. And after a period of time, we also learned that there are people who simply sign up and not show up. And there are also people who cancel the trip right before the trip departs. We don't want that to happen. So we love our travelers, but we dislike those who don't show up. So I've been working so hard with a lot of people at this community, including our fascinating weekend coordinators, our administration DAs, as well as the weekend duty crews. So first, I came up with this solution here. We call it Polaris Dollar, and I brought this to our statistics professor, teacher Elson, and we killed the plan after our discussion. Reason are two. First, the first thing we thought was, we don't want to introduce something that's monetary to this community, because this is a Quaker community. Secondly, we've also learned that the weekend program want more people to participate in different activities. We didn't want to dissuade them from joining different trips. So we've came up with a much better solution. And here it is. encourage more weekend activity participation. That's the topo of this whole program. The second thing we learned, obviously, we wanted to protect integrity of players. So we want people to show up to the things they sign up for, and we don't want people to cancel their trips right before they actually depart. So how are we going to do it? We're introducing Polaris Points. And to tell you more about Polaris Points, let me invite up the weekend coordinators, teacher Mauricio and teacher Kristen.
Hey folks, so Kevin's done a pretty good job of explaining sort of how this came about. We love travelers. We love students who come to trips to participate in the weekend. But we wanted to preserve the integrity of the weekend, the integrity of Polaris, and we wanted to make sure that the weekend program was efficient, effective, and fun. So we, working collaboratively with Kevin, instituted a kind of credit system. So there are ways to gain credit and improve your credit score, and there are also ways of losing it. Missing one without canceling one, you accrue credit through Polaris. If you miss them, or if you cancel them, you lose credit. So here's how it works. If you miss a trip altogether, that's gonna have a really adverse effect on your credit. If you cancel late, there'll still be a negative impact on your Polaris points credit, but it'll be sort of lesser. And so we've got a kind of a graph, a distribution of penalty points. So if you sign up and cancel within 24 hours, there won't be a penalty on your Polaris points credit. And obviously that penalty increases as you get to departure. And if you cancel like right as the trip unfolds, you take on the full penalty to your credit score. I won't say too much more about how this is gonna work out because Kevin's gonna say those things. But it's been a pleasure for us to work with Kevin and to do our best to incorporate the technologies and the talent that we have on campus to improving the weekend program.
So that's a sneak peek at the Polaris Points. So what are we gonna do with points? Well, the first thing I want to tell you that Polaris has, since its initial release, we've been modeled this whole thing after the airline industry. So when you sign for trips, you have a wait list, and so does every flight in the airline business. And you also have a purchase ticket, which is basically how you sign up. You also get a seat who's on the wait list. All of these amazing features come from the airline industry, or inspired from the airline industry. And so does Polaris Club. So we're introducing different membership levels. Now, let me just switch over some technology problems. Okay. Oh, there we go. So we have Polaris members. That's our base level. And you also have silver, which everyone starts at, and it resets every semester. You can go up to gold. And you have concierge key, which is our secret level of membership. So this membership level will be nominated by the weekend coordinators, and there will be 9 people per semester for concierge key. And here are some of the benefits you get. So I'm going to just pick out 2. So first one is called Polaris Fest, which essentially is once per semester event. It could be a pizza party, and it could be a free movie ticket to show our appreciation to our top level members. Because we know that if we give you some incentive, you're going to achieve it. What we tell you to do, right? There's also, like the weekend coordinator said, there will be a cancellation penalty, but for our top level spenders, we'll be offering reduced for gold members and waived for our concierge key, because there's not a lot of them. Number 2, how do you get to know your status? It's quite simple. Well, so now you can simply go onto Polaris, log in, and tap on the top left corner. There's a little button you can click on. And once you click on, a little menu will slide out. You can see your status instantly. And additionally, if you want to learn more about the program, you can click on the club. If you can see it, if you click on the club button in there, in the menu, you can see a club page. You can see your card, your lifetime trips, as well as some of the benefits you will receive as a member of Polaris Club. Now, number three. Well, number three is actually for our duty crew members. The weekend program is not possible without the amazing Falcon members who drive us to different places, and we really, really want to show our appreciation. And in fact, there are the people who complain the most about Polaris, to be honest, which is why, well, they give us a lot of feedback, they give us a lot of advice, and sometimes critiques. So to address their needs, we've actually learned a lot through this process of working with them every weekend. So they're dropping into different duty meetings on weekends, talking to VAs, doing short interviews, and using Polaris Weekend myself. I've actually come up with a lot of great new features. So the first thing we learned, after first week we released Polaris, we learned that our user interface for duty crew was awful. Which is why we're introducing a new one here. There are four buttons you can click on. You can check attendance, you can do locations, get a navigation to your destination. You can change the time of this trip, and you can even add comments right now. So originally, we've also had a really, really decent, I'd say, attendance sheet that you can take attendance with. Originally, there's only one button, which is a plus sign. It's kind of confusing for a lot of people because it could be indicating the status of this person, or it could also be a button. And a lot of people cannot tell which is which. Neither can I. Which is why we're introducing this second menu control here. So you can see absent and on trip, and you can switch between them very easily. So, and also we've learned that there are people, there are also duty crew members who are having trouble keeping track of how many people are signed in already. So which is why we included a little camera at the very bottom so you can see that how many people we were checking. We've also learned after 4 weeks of our release, that there are people who simply show up and without signing up. That's a good thing, but it creates some trouble. So we're introduced to something called add. You can simply type the person's name in the text field at the bottom. As you start typing, it auto-completes for you, and you click on the person's name, and then when you click on the add sign, it pops right into your attendance sheet and mark S on trip. And these are some of the good features for duty crew members. Also, do you guys still remember this?
Yes.
This is what we call a van sign-out form. A van sign-out form, basically, you would write your name down on it, and it's still around. The intention of Polaris was to eliminate this. And through our various research, we learned that this is not possible. Why? Because the Pennsylvania law requires all school buses, vans, and minivans to carry a attendance sheet like this, so that in case of some accident, you can tell who's on the bus or the van. So we think, why don't we just, since we can't take it away, what about changing it a little bit to make it more streamlined? So today we're announcing remote printing. How does it work? You can simply go to duty crew view, and since you would need attendance, you can take attendance on it. After you're finished taking attendance, you can click on print. So what print does is basically it prints attendance sheet right to the printer in Barry Lee's room. And you can pick it up and take it with you, and you're done. You don't even have to give this sheet to the upper school office because all the attendance data has been delivered electronically. Well, there is one more thing before you end. And we simply can't appreciate more moments like these. Here's another one. It's groups like these that inspire us with new ideas to create more creative methods, solutions to solve a real world problem in our community and beyond. And here's a little scratch work of ours of West End Weekend. Believe it or not, it used to be called West End Weekend. And we just simply love moments like these where we get to work on something really cool that also changes the life of people in our community and beyond. We want to inspire more people to do the same, which is why I am so excited to announce today that Resort and Polaris are open source. Woo-hoo. Meaning that every citizen, this means that every single person around the world can access our source code. Anyone can access our source code. You can improve upon it, you can build upon it, you can even create some other cool things with our code. You can even learn how to code with our code. And specific to Polaris, we're introducing something called Polaris APIs. So this allows you to gain access to our entire database, and then allows you to do something really, really cool, including doing a mathematical modeling project in math class, or do something like this, the weekend departure board. This is a project that's been done by a current CS student, Brian Kim, and you can see this in Central, which this departure board tells you what trips there are, the upcoming trips, and when they depart. And we cannot appreciate products like these more. And we want more people to do the same. Now, before I end, I would like to thank all of you who have helped me throughout my journey here of creating Resort Polaris and some other cool projects that you guys don't know. Specifically, I want to thank Teacher Margaret, Teacher Kristen, and Teacher Mauricio, Teacher Tom Gilbert, I don't know where he is, and the Dean Smith. Oh, there he is. And I want to thank all of those who've been helping with this project. Teacher Larry in the back, Teacher Greg is videotaping this whole presentation, and many more people for this journey. And thank you all. And for Polaris and some of the greatest updates that are available today, and that's Westtown Resort and Polaris. Thank you all very much.